I hope that they're gonna do well, but still, my favor still goes to Newbee, and we'll see what's gonna happen.
I mean, I did see a similar statement coming out from Newbee on Twitter today. I think they tweeted something along the lines of "Nothing is given, everything is earned." I think that's a nice motto to see them through this group. And looks like the banner. It looks like the draft is about to begin. I'm just tripping over my words. And let's jump straight on in.
I was going to say, no Naga Siren Ban, but they do end up banning it because NP would love to snatch that up if they ever got the chance. No, will be Shadow Demon instead. We saw previous game, it was Shadow Demon Luna, wasn't it? So they do like to play for the late game. And Shadow Demon Luna, if they can do that again, they would. So Jack, what do you expect to come to see here from Team Newbee?
Jump in. I think you're going to see something probably in Axe or Sand King early on in the pick phase. I think that's where they usually go to. As I say that, that's not what happened. But they often try to hide SCCC's hero in the draft. And so with this draw, we could see an OD or something like that coming out mid later on that they want to protect their Miracle-esque player.
And now you can take advantage. You've got the draw there. You can take advantage of the fact you have the last overall pick in the draft. So you have the 10th pick. No, nothing can be picked to counter it. The only thing NP can do to protect themselves is by banning out things that could cause them problems. So this is like the draw enables and makes so many mid-heroes that much better. So it's a really good position to be in as far as picking SCC's hero later on the draft.
You're going to see that duo. It's back.
So what's the scariest hero for that SCC has for up against like if you give him a draw aura, which one do you definitely not want to face?
Ooh, good question.
Well, I would lean towards an OD in a draft like this, especially with the ability to clear illusions. You're gonna see that obviously from the SD. Otherwise, I would have said, maybe something like a Timbersaw doesn't synergize as much with the aura as well. So that's also very scary. And of course, the Invoker signature hero.
We saw the TA earlier today. He actually got the first Rampage of the tournament playing a Templar Assassin. So that's another consideration, I'd say. But I mean, it's one of those things where there's so many scary heroes that he's so flexible that there's not like one hero that's going to stand out as being the worst of them.
Just reflecting upon some of those bans, we did see Rubick taken away by NP.
Yeah. And NP seems to be targeting, I think they're kind of saying, well, there's a lot of mid heroes, let's ban out some of the KP heroes. So they ban the Sand King, they may even ban the Slaughter as well, because KP's hero pool is a lot more limited. But some of the numbers before the match we saw, he has like his two most played heroes, Sand King and Slaughter, he plays way more than anything else. They were like 20% of his played heroes each, so.
Something you said to me before at the start of this segment was regarding NP and having a predictable draft. Is that like something that you believe is necessarily a downside to NP? They have a predictable nature to their draft?
No, not necessarily.
I'd say like VP have a predictable draft. Like you know what VP's going to do. They just do it so well and you can't beat it. Yeah. But it does give you the ability to prepare for them and choose, like pick your poison a bit. Like, okay, we're going to give them this and prepare a strategy like in advance to beat it, whereas Wings is the complete opposite, where you have no idea what. Game one, they have an opening two picks, and then game two will be saying radically different with no clear reason. EG is the same thing, they'll do saying completely different from game one to game two.
So, it is the MSS Timbersaw that Newbee is afraid of. They remove that, and they remove also Envy's Mirana, so we'll be curious to see what's gonna end up in the mid lane. That mid lane is gonna be very exciting to watch and see, because Envy struggles a little bit with the mid lane. We've seen it before, and obviously he is a hero, or player rather, that can catch up, and he's great with that. But today, overall, his Queens of Pains haven't been exactly
It does seem
amazing.
Like they've given up on that now.
That, thank God, yes.
Well, I say that a little ahead of
for
time.
Now,
yeah,
but,
for now.
Yeah.
He's a player whose his laning stage isn't his forte. That's his weak point as a mid laner.
But it is something that Newbee can definitely exploit.
Yeah.
So where do his strengths lie then? If he's not necessarily, the most phenomenal laner.
His decision-making, his ability, his itemization, decision-making is probably the biggest thing, where he knows how to get the most out of his hero in the mid to late game.
Right.
He's one of the best late game decision-making players, carries or mids out there.
Yeah, I described to have high highs and low lows, Eternal Envy.
That is the way.
No one is the artist in China mentioned this before, as meme goes, because he sees things sometimes that nobody else does, and he makes these decisions, as you said.
Ooh.
Okay, so the Ring of Basilia's mid, I'm not sure if he still does it, but that amazed me. That he could, like, right before an enemy would last hit, he would toggle his ring on so that it has a little bit more armor, so that it gets, you try to last hit and you just have a little bit of health left so he can deny it. I mean, that was, for me, mind-blowing the first time I heard that he actually bought that ring because of that, just for that tiny gimmicky thing. It's crazy, but he is the person that comes up with those things. Or I believe Merlini came up with it at some point, someone in a very past future. future for past. In a very distant past.
Very distant past. Came up with this.
Came up with this, yes.
It is. I mean, you say it's a minor difference. It is just those little increments that can push you over the finish line. So we are going to be seeing another Slardar. Seems to be quite a regular presence in the drafts today.
Yeah, I was thinking the Batrider comes out really often. This is something you pair up with the Silencer because you get the Blink Lasso and then you immediately Global Silence. So there's no, it's impossible to counter initiate. You get one of your heroes picked off, and normally you have like a Oracle or some kind of way to save them, Avenge Swap, whatever it may be, or even just a Slardar Blink crushing in. But the instant Global Silence combos really well with the Batrider.
A way to separate, you know, your big heroes.
And this is taking a page out of VP's book. You got the Slardar Darkseer commonly banned against them. This kind of bullying off lane, I think, that they're going to run at NewB, seeing that they have the Drow, who doesn't do that much early on in the lane. And so that's going to be interesting. I thought they were going to go in a different direction, maybe an Omni or Baden, another kind of NA off lane to help deal with the single target from the Batrider and the single target damage that NewB has right now. But it is the Darkseer.
Darkseer is nice because he builds naturally into the Greaves, so you purge off the Global Silence, which I like about the hero. But
how do you guys feel about running an aggressive tri lane with the Luna, Slardar, and Shadow Demon into a Drow lane? Is that an option, or is it preferably going to be the dual lanes coming out from that?
Can work. The Ogre would have to then kind of rotate to make sure you get that tri lane versus tri lane action happening, but I don't. There's no reason why it doesn't work, because Luna aura giving them all the bonus damage, it means they can actually contest the lane, but it's a bit hard because Luna's got the short range against the Drow Ranger.
We've talked so much about, you know, Shadow Demon Luna being a scary combo. We've seen evidence of it, in fact, very recently in the previous game. When you talk about countering that or kind of hindering that, what do you look for in the draft to stop the Luna or Shadow Demon illusion party?
So either you want to be faster than that strategy is, which is something that I think that NewB can already do by the default, but you also want to have heroes that can clear illusions.
Just clear them as soon as possible.
Yeah. And so far, I mean, they're not amazing at clearing illusions, to be honest.
Now, if you look at the OD ban, I like the starter pick because I think it took it away from NewB, who are very likely looking at it themselves. And I like this Alchemist pick mid as well.
Instant Morphling, though. Wow,
that's quick.
It's weird because it's somewhat accounted. They picked it very quickly, but if they take more time, be like, well, yeah, they want to pick Morphling against the Alk because you make a replicate of him. Suddenly you've got you get to take plenty of aura items he gets. You get obviously a big Chemical Rage Alchemist on your side. So I think it is picked up against the Alchemist. It was just surprising how fast they picked it against the Alchemist.
They knew it. I mean, they can even make a copy of the Luna.
That's true.
That's great too.
Okay.
Illusions. More illusions.
So the draft hasn't raised any too many red flags. Hasn't changed your predictions in any way.
It has not changed my prediction.
Feeling good.
I think I like MP's draft a bit better. I think the Darkseer Slardar lane can really pressure a lot. I think the Alchemist, there's not any great ways of beating the Alchemist as much as Morphling means you can create an Alchemist illusion yourself. I think Alk is just going to confirm incredibly fast. So I think NP's draft may win it for them.
Giving NP the edge, gods. All right, well, on that bombshell, let's head over to your casters, and they are bombshells themselves. We'll head over to your casters to guide you through our final game of the day. Of course, Winter hanging out.
Thank you very much, Alex. Indeed, we're ready to get into the final series of Group B. It is MP versus NewB. I'm OD Pixel. I'm going to be joined by Winter for this lovely, lovely little game. Alchemist, Morphling, what's the dealio here? Who's coming out on top?
Dude, Alchemist, Morphling, Shadow Demon, Luna. Illusions.
Illusions. They thought they nerfed it. Hey, Ice Frog, where you at now, mate? Anyway, we should be able to get ourselves into the game. It's all kicking off. So, I mean, let's talk about this as we go through both of the sides. As you said, it's a lot of illusion base coming out. Who do you favor? Who's come out on top of this draft? Do you feel that both teams got their strength? But talk to me about the Silencer pick. We don't see teams do that every day.
Well, firstly, about the lineups, I think I personally prefer to be on MP's lineup.
Okay.
Easier to execute it with the SD, Luna, and Alchemist. And I don't think NewB would be able to put a lot of pressure in the early game to slow down the Alchemist too much. I think he should still be able to get his farm. I mean, it depends on what the Ogre wants. If he decides to help the Batrider, because if he pressures the Alchemist, he's not going to be able to help the Bat in the bottom lane, Batrider against the Luna SC lane. He shouldn't get too much, so it's about preference whether NewB decides to pressure the Alchemist or to help out their Batrider. It's too many things they need to, you know, handle in the early game where you can only choose to help out one.
Very nice. Here for KP, sign off the game, and we'll be able to pick up the Ops Ward of MP, making his offlane that little bit easier. And I mean, I guess that is one of the questions to ask as well. How hard is it going to be for KP down here on this Batrider?
All going to be up to the Ogre, whether you help him, or you're going to just choose to prioritize shutting down the Alchemist. Back to the Silencer pick. I think NewB just is one of the few teams that you know, they rate the hero very highly as a position 5 support. You zone the offlaner very well. You're very valuable as a position 5 support because of your global. And he packs a punch, you know, if you get a lot of intelligence.
I mean, I guess that's the thing. As you said, Silence is very good against an offlane hero, but he's having to deal with two. On this top lane, we are going to have this combination of the Slardar, Darkseer. How much can a Silence do against the both of them?
Not really that great against multiple heroes on the offlane. He's really good at zoning one, but I do agree that he's not that great against two heroes, three heroes, but later into the game, he's very useful as a support. Not only for the global, but he has a lot of damage from his spells and his right click. Not something that you should underestimate with the draw aura.
That's true. That's absolutely true. And in fact, top lane Faith, he's kind of wandered over here to have a bit of a look in onto this top lane. SVG and MSS able to give him a fair bit of a punch back there with the Iron Shell.
Yeah, one thing I wanted to talk about as well is the idea of having the morphling against Alchemist, because you morph a lot of agility, so you have a lot of armor to withstand the harass from the acid spray, and you have a lot of damage, so you are able to deny the creeps. So if you look at the mid lane CS right now, SCC so far has been able to deny 4 of Alchemist creeps, so that's really huge for the laning phase against Alc. You want to slow him down as much as you can.
Yeah, and I guess with MP's dual lanes as well, does it feel like they don't really have many options in terms of sending a hero mid to help out Envy? They've got to kind of leave him on his own for the laning stage.
Yeah, I think look at what they're doing right now.
I mean, top lane.
They're pressuring them so much, and they're going to... Oh, SVG's going to go down first.
Yeah, looks like they kind of went a bit over-aggressive there, MP, and in fact, if they pay with anything else, MSS will be chased down, but he has the surge, but what a way to give up first blood. They're diving behind the tier 1.
They were, like, really, really aggressive there, because they had a lot of creeps. They pushed the creeps with Iron Shell, so they felt like they were in position to actually try to make an aggressive move there. But like I said, the silencer support is not something that you should underestimate. He packs a punch and he deals a lot of damage. And diving there was clearly not a good choice for MP, and the Ogre was also in the vicinity there. So it was not a very good trade for MP.
And bottom lane here, this is good news for MP as they surround KP, and with a good crush from SVG, allowing the boys to get themselves a kill and return. So now bringing it to 1-1 on the board.
Yep.
And both safe laners finding a bit of action.
Back to your question where you were asking me if MP should send the supports to help Envy, but I think that what they are doing right now is okay. They are putting a lot of pressure, especially on SVG. He's pressuring the other lanes, he's pressuring the top lane, he just rotated bottom to kill the Batrider. If he's doing something elsewhere, he's forcing the Ogre to move away from the middle lane. As long as the Ogre's not in the middle lane, and basically the SD can stack whenever he can, or the Alchemist would just stack on his own, like, he'll be fine. I don't think they need to, you know, have a support in the lane all the time to help him.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, some good stacks coming out that Envy's going to be able to utilize. And indeed, just keep him on par. And what, if anything, being an Alchemist, get him ahead of SCCC.
Yep, and that bounty rune, you know, it's all about the bounty runes, securing the bounty runes. Like, I don't think people mention it enough when they're talking about the game, how important it is for Alchemists to get all those early bounty runes.
Absolutely, I can rectify kind of a bad kind of CS stage in the laning. Obviously, as we saw 2 minutes in, Envy did try and get the top rune, but Kakarot the Silencer was able to nab it from him, so a bit, little painful there, sending him back a bit more.
It is also the same for playing against Alchemists. You have to secure the runes. And right now, SVG back towards the top lane, and Darkseer is on his way up, so they're going to be resuming their dual lane pressure here against the Draw Ranger. But so far, he's still farming relatively well. It's 16 last hits against the Luna's 19.
Yeah, and the thing is as well that both MSS and SVG, they're not really finding much CS themselves, even the Darkseer. MSS struggling to find stuff with the Iron Shell.
Keeping the Ogre here, I think keeping the Ogre here is the more important thing for... Because you're indirectly protecting your Alchemist when you're doing this, because the Ogre can't really move and pressure the other
one. SVG has to be a little bit careful, and he's going to come in with a crush, but he's been cursed up as Kakarot and Faith surround him, and indeed, this is going to continue to tick him down with the Ignite as well. He's going to try for the TP out. Oh, he didn't right-click!
He didn't right-click him!
He didn't right-click him! Oh!
Okay, that was...
He must have tried to walk through the trees, and I guess didn't expect him to be right under his nose.
You know, that's why when you do this kind of move, you put you click A on A click on the ground, so you will always get the right click off.
Wise words, Winter. he's going to be kicking himself for that one, and
I missed
MP very lucky there.
By newbie, but you know, it's not a big deal at the end of the day. I mean, your cores are still farming. That's what that matters the most right now, and morphing is getting more farm than the Alchemist, but I think it's fine with Alchemist. He's like only a few creeps behind, and as long as you're getting the bounty runes and you have stacks.
And he's got these stacks, which is great. Oh, we're going to see the replay as well. So, I mean, are we sure if Faith got that touch, he would have definitely got the kill, wouldn't he?
Yep, he would have.
Oh, as we saw that player perspective. Okay, so it looked like he didn't just he didn't quite have the chance to get the vision. It was a little bit of an awkward spot around the trees there. But very, very, very close.
Yep, and right now, NewB making a move here. It's night time. A lot of teams do this.
KP looking for the bait, you see, trying to make MP go in on him. And that's going to allow the side of NewB to get this really deep, nice wraparound on both Aoi, Amrose, and income Faith and Kaka. I don't think MP were expecting this one. Fire Blast onto Aoi. They're going to look to focus down Rose first. As NewB find not just one, but they should get the second. Yep. Indeed, with the curse, they will. Aoi tries with the sail to keep him alive in the stick. Ooh, he's actually going to be able to juke this out for a little bit, but Faith and Kaka, they'll continue to hunt. Kaka dealing intel, already looking pretty good for this silence. So 6 minutes in and six intel in the bag.
That's a big, big rotation from NewB. Like I said, moving during the nighttime, the first night phase. Really, really good timing to move. It's easier to get ganks done with the nighttime vision. And very well played by NewB. Like KP there baiting them into a really bad position. And even though he was really low, he wasn't trying to run away. He was still stacking up the napalm and making sure that his team gets the kill.
Yeah, KP, yeah, as you said, just very well calculated his movement. Mid lane, MV as we see is caught up in CS due to the stacks. Top lane's actually going to be where the action happens as Aoi. TP's back into the game, up towards top. Unite tries to go for the Gust and TP out.
Close.
It was a good attempt, but indeed not quite enough to save him. And MP getting themselves a good kill onto the core and return. And indeed, bottom lane, SVG trying for the TP out himself. He's not going to make it, Kaka. He's not even going to go down to the tower here. This support silencer. I mean, it's really worked out for NewB. Their movements and calls to make are certainly helping them keep a strong foothold in this early game.
Envy went for power treads? Is he going to go for...
Is he going to be the Basilan? The treads, medallion, solo crest, shadow blade?
I'm thinking if he's going to go for that build.
Do you like the decision too, if he does indeed go that way?
Usually when you go that route, you're expecting a lot of pressure from the enemy and you think that going for the Radiance build is way too greedy. So maybe he's trying to figure out, maybe he hasn't made up his mind for sure yet. Like power trips into Radiance, Armlet Radiance is still fine, I think. But I think overall that build is pretty legit. I like the build a lot when you're going up against a lot of pressure. Bottom lane.
I mean, KP again, this man plays really on the edge, and KP actually with a bit of a miscalculation. Coming in too close to the tower, taking two hits, and that is a tasty bit of free gold there for SVG on the slaughter. That was a little uncharacteristic.
In the meantime as well, Aoi took the tier 1 at top, so that was huge.
Yeah, MP with some nice momentum there.
Right now, NewB are going to get try to pressure the bottom tier 1 as well. They should be able to get this tower. Doesn't seem like MP is in position to defend this. They are choosing to get... Well, Envy is farming the enemy stack.
He's trying to take KP's farm. KP's having none of it, though. He's going to start and play around with the Firefly. Has to be a bit careful. Oh, no, KP! Oh, my goodness. He can't let himself go down again. He's got it.
He doesn't want to let the stacks go to the Alchemist as well. Like, he's trying desperately to get the farm.
Now, let's see who gets the gold. Well, that's... it's kind of going half and half at the moment, but it looks like is Envy going to be able to finish off the big creeps? Indeed he is. He gets both of the big creeps, yeah. Envy will successfully kill a good chunk of KP's farm.
Well, bounty rune on top of that. Why not?
looks like the stars are lining up for Envy.
Yeah, I guess he's still going to go back for the Radiance build at this rate. Like, he hasn't gotten any early points in the stun. If you're going for the solo quest build, you want to get your extra points in stun early instead of maxing your greed. So he thinks that he's going to be able to get away with it, and they have the Shadow Demon Luna, so their mid to late game is going to be extremely potent if he's going to be able to pull off the Radiance in a good time.
Yeah, look at this warning as well. They see four heroes on the map, so Aoi has this confidence to head up top. And yeah, mid lane, it's where NewB are really trying to make something happen. The warning from MP spotted that whole movement around that they kind of wrapped through on the jungle, and now obviously just revealing themselves in mid lane. MP, they're aware of what's going on, so we'll see if they do anything here. They may just let this tower be and have to give this one up to NewB. And I thought that will be the case. And so at this stage of the game, MP, it just feels like they're not quite ready, are they, to try and stop a drow push onto a tier 1.
And this is some good stuff from NewB as well. Generally, when you see Silencer being picked up as a support, you don't expect the Silencer to be moving around. Like, he's been moving around since minute 5.
He's been incredibly active, Kaka.
Like, you expect Silencer to be that support which carries the TP to react, and he's being in the lane constantly pulling to get levels, but no, Kaka has been really active, helping the team secure kills.
Oh, actually, and down in the Radiant Jungle,
Envy.
Yeah, we're going to see Envy being playing around there, but U9 was found out, and in fact, he's trying to get himself towards the rune. It's going to be nabbed from right underneath his nose, and SVG and MSS, they were stood there, and U9 kind of walks up to the jungle at that choke point on his own.
Didn't they have vision? Like, they had a ward?
They did. There is a dire observer ward there. And he just kind of walked up the steps into the boys, so... a little bit. Strange plays there.
So, maybe lose the carry. They didn't get kill on the Alchemist on the rune, so... few sequence of events that favors MP very, very much in the last minute. And right now, NB is on his way to his Radiance. He gets up the Armlet. So he's going to be really, really hard to kill right now. Armlet and Treads.
Yeah, now he as well getting himself some good ancient stacks. This is all under the eyes of NewB though. They know exactly what's going on, but not a lot they can do in terms of contesting that.
Yeah, but this is very worrisome for NewB, where the Batrider's dagger is going to be extremely slow because of the stacks getting stolen. And if you look at the big picture of things, like SVG on his starter might get the blink at around the same time as the Batrider. This is not looking good for NewB. If the two teams are continuously trading farm, I think MP will be much more comfortable with the position.
Ooh, they have walked into Howie, and that would be a perfect pickoff to find. They have a global silence available if necessary. It looks like they'll be able to get the pickoff without it, dragging him back with the lasso and allowing SCCC to pick up the kill. A very, very nice find for NewB, sweeping into the jungle.
They really needed that very, very badly, as the game is not going too well for them. Both teams are passively farming.
Oh.
It's going to favor the Alchemist side.
Courier? What? They saw him there because they kind of backed it back away, but then they just let it fly back over him. I don't know what's quite happening here.
Well, maybe the person who's using it was talking to someone and he didn't notice the morphing.
I mean, there must have been some miscommunication there.
Yeah, someone else was trying to use the courier and he was like, he was talking and then it happens.
Oh, courier down. Nice bit of gold for NewB.
Yep, shit happened, so... Right now for NewB, they're still really concerned about this Alchemist because they are not being able to get any kills on him, like with all the smokes. They've been killing the other heroes, but not the Alchemist. I mean, the Luna kill was great, the last one, but the previous few ganks, they only got the supports. And so the Alchemist has so far been left untouched. He cleared all his stacks. I mean, he's going to be well on his way to his Radiance, despite it not being the fastest timing because he went for the power traits.
We'll see what they can get done down here on the bottom lane. MP coming in for a tier 1 push. SCCC and Kaka in the neighborhood. A bit of a go on to the Morphling there. MP as he forces him back. The replica will be quickly taken down though. I'll bring that out. He's going to be able to survive for a bit, but not a lot of use NewB can make it of it here. Is there? Not actually going to jump in, but at the same time, MP being very careful about how they're pushing onto this tier 1, and they're actually going to avoid the fight.
They were trying to pressure when they knew KP doesn't have lasso, but his lasso is back up right now, so they're backing off. If you look at the builds MP went for, Aoi went for first item, Helm of Dom, so it's one of the most farm-centric builds that you can go for on the Luna. And Alchemist going for Radiance, and you have the Darkseer pushing out lane, so MP is going to be really looking to play a very slow and passive game. They're going to try to farm up as much as they can before the Slalak gets his blink. Once the blink comes online, then they're going to be starting to look to fight. But right now, they are really, really content in, you know, just farming, stacking up the jungle, ancients, whatever they can get their hands on.
And KP actually smoked up for this move. He's on his own.
He has his dagger. Yes, it's more than enough gold for the dagger soon. So Roshan going down and using the Firefly in the mid lane. Didn't expect the blink to come at 14, 2 minutes ago.
No, he's really cleaned up. I had a bit of a rocky start, KP.
Yeah, the Luna kill was really huge for KP. And right now, they got the Roshan as well on top of that. So NewB gonna be in a good position to pressure. Because against what NP have, NewB needs to constantly pressure them, take towers, force fights if possible, get objectives, and you know, secure map control. They can't let MP, you know, be farming contently the whole map.
And as we saw there from that beautiful camera shot, the blink dagger now safely and securely delivered to KP. And they want to make something happen with this, I guess. You know, we have SCCC having the Aegis and actually finding Rose here on his own with a global silence to make sure no defensive disruption or backup comes out.
Kill secured, I would call that.
I mean, that is the global silence down for a couple of minutes, you get the kill.
I guess they were like worried about maybe a self-destruct.
And look at Envy's build. He's going for the Maelstrom Winter.
Oh, he changed his mind. Okay.
What did you think about that decision? Because he obviously was starting to stockpile the gold, and it did look indeed like he was going to go for the more standard, but suddenly, bam, Maelstrom comes out.
Well, this is the reason why I was like thinking about whether the Alchemist would go for the solo quest field, because this game against the draw, I was worried that they might be under a lot of pressure, and maybe he was like considering the possible option of going for another build, a less greedy build, because you're up against the draw. If you go for the Radiance build, it's going to take some time. Unless you have a super good start.
KP indeed. He finds the last of that he was looking for as SVG was not expecting the jump on him from the back.
That was huge. He was close to his blink on the Slada. So that was a big pick off there on SVG.
KP just getting his own one out and showing it in the face of SVG and saying, where's yours at now, mate? And indeed, as you said, knocked back a little bit there, SVG on the Slada. And 7-4, I mean, obviously in this game, there's definitely strengths for both sides showing. MV, he's finding the timing. It's obviously going to be interesting to see what he gets done with this Maelstrom and see if he turns up to fights and such. I mean, is that the plan? Because surely if you were going to farm, you would just pick up the Radiance. Is this MV saying, team needs me in these engagements?
He's still farming though. I think maybe the other possible reason why he's doing this is because of the Morphling Replicate, so you don't want to give him a Radiance Illusion.
Is true. So I think that's it, Winter.
I'm not sure
it.
If it's the main reason.
I reckon that's got to be 90% of the reason.
Because you could also put the argument that you have a Shadow Demon, so you want to have the Radiance Illusions on your Shadow Demon.
Okay, 80% of the reason.
I don't know, but it seems rather strange going for this build, but this is the only reason I can feel why he actually wanted to go for the Maelstrom build.
Well, look at this here from MP, ready for some aggressive maneuver. They're smoking up, looking to wrap around behind Newbee. S-triple-C the one furthest forward at the moment, but he does have a replicate out.
He has Aegis, though.
It's a very hard hero to try and make a jump on, and he's already out there to the illusion.
It's possible they were kind of banking on someone else to be on around the vicinity, and they were just really trying to get any pickoff they can find, but... Right now, SVG still 400 shot of that blink.
I mean, talking about blink, what's Kaka going for? He's got enough money for a blink himself. I mean, he's not bought the Midas, and he's had the money for a bit of time. He's building about 2.3k gold in the silencer's hand.
There's no certain, there's no fixed build for a silencer.
There's a lot of flexibility for silencers.
You can go for a 4-star, a glimmer. You can go for anything your team needs, I think. There's no set build on the hero. That's one early Mjolnir on the Alchemist, 17 minutes in.
17 minutes. It's going to be interesting to see the potency of it. Obviously, kind of like the Radiance, it does help with the farming because of the lightning procs, but in terms of turning up to the fight and such, I'll see how effective it is going to be against NewB's lineup. SVG with that Blink Dagger could be the key to get MP to join forces, bring the Alk into the fight and find a pickoff, or find a fight.
I mean, right now the Alchemist has only 2 points in stun. He probably wants to fight maybe in a few more levels when he has the stun maxed out. Then he wants to keep focus on trying to get, I think especially the silencer, you want to pick up the silencer before anything happens. That's your key hero. So you take the global silence out of the picture. Has he purchased anything? No, he still has 2.5k.
2.5k on there. Is he going straight up Hex?
Hex
first item?
I mean, Hex is really good on silencer.
Yeah, if he can get a Hex, as that really could be incredibly potent in this matchup. E-Blade is now done.
What other options?
On the Morphling.
What other options that he could possibly be thinking of? Lotus Orb isn't. Nah, not Lotus Orb. Not this game, probably. I think Hex is probably the biggest item and the most impactful item.
Oh, look at this wraparound though for NewB. They're coming around from the backside. KP getting a good jump onto the Alchemist. The global silence coming out from Kaka. They try and get in with the Slada. Gust out as well, as they've taken down Alchemist as well as Rose. SVG to be beaten down upon as well. And that is the combo that we talked about there. The Batrider blink.
Gosh.
And the global silence.
Did you see that timing? The Slada blink in and he was
silence
crushing and the global came out.
Yeah, I think we might even be able to check back on a replay of the perspective of KP.
Gosh,
there on that one.
So close. That was 0.1 of a second remaining before he cast his crush. Might have been able to save the Alchemist there, and the global comes out at the perfect time.
Yeah, incredibly clutch play from NewB. They secured themselves the towers as well, and not only the fight.
4K right
what
now.
Is he? let's watch this though. Look, this is KP's perspective. And instantly sees Envy, knows it's safe to go, and we can also see that slide up. Bam, jumps in, but the global's already out. And suddenly, MP are kind of caught in a position where they just can't achieve anything at all. You see Envy try and get the lightning shield out to him, but it does very little at this stage with the speed that NewB taken down.
By the way, we got our answer. He bought a 4-star.
He brought a 4-star.
I think he was thinking...
How anticlimactic.
He was thinking about something else, like probably going for a hex straight, and then 4-star is great.
Maybe his morph was like baby raging. He was like, the Alk's not built a Radiant. Silencer, get on that now. I need to make illusions of someone with the Radiant. Kaka, this is your job. And then Kaka was like, stop being silly. I'm building a 4-star. You're being very, very silly, SCCC. But in all honesty, SCCC, he's not. He's 303. He's working on the Manta, I imagine. That's the E-Blade.
Oh, he has a...
He's got the Blade of Alacrity.
Blade of Alacrity. Looks like the Manta here.
And 20 minutes in, it's looking very good for him, but... Envy as well on the Alchemist. We'll see where his build progresses post-Mione. What are you kind of expecting to see from Envy now? It's just a follow-up still. You think AC over Manta and such?
Because he doesn't have a Radiant, so I don't think he wants Manta.
Okay. No, even against like, you have the Silencer and the Drow, is that not something you need to be that worried about?
Here comes SEC.
Yeah, here comes the pain from Newbee. KP in onto MSS, and he's quickly out, accepts his fate and stands there for the show. It's getting a little bit gruesome here at MP. 11-4 for Newbee. SCCC in a place that he needs to be. How are you still farming relatively well? He's absolutely on par, and if not just ahead of the Drow Ranger. So how are you still in a good place? It's all going to be about how well MP can utilize the team composition and items that they built up in the fights against what NewB have. As we've seen, if NewB get a good jump onto MP, it's sort of borderline impossible for them to fight back into that global silence if it comes out well.
Against the global, it's definitely not possible for them until they have their Greaves, until they have their Lotus off. But before those items come online for MP, it's going to be like close to impossible for them to take a fight. But then again, their heroes are really good at pushing out the links. The Darkseer Iron Shell, Alchemist with the Acid, and you know, the Mjolnir. Good ways of making sure that the lanes are always pushed out. So even if you give off a pickoff against the Bear Rider plus the global, you make sure that newbie can't, you know, siege your base. And then you try to make a play after, because global is still a really long cooldown.
I kind of like this as well. Envy going for the playmaker, but he's picked up a Blink Dagger.
And this is pretty good too.
Yeah.
It's going to allow him to, you know, especially the Drow, because Drow is still a very squishy target if you can actually get the stun and blink on her.
I'm just going to see down bottom. You playing around with an illusion. Top lane, though, Rose is the one with the bigger issues. Yubi getting a kill and actually trying to fight around through the backdoor protection of that tower, which they won't actually even need to do so very shortly with the wave pushing in.
Yep.
Envy, he sees himself a freebie.
Freebie.
Ay, ay, ay.
Didn't he have a blink?
I did. Can we get a replay of that? I want to see a player perspective replay. I don't know if production can do that.
Oh, he almost died to the side. Dude. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Holy shit. He actually almost died to a support silencer.
That was...
He actually almost died there.
Fascinating. Radiant structures are fortified. Really, really was. On top lane, they've nearly found themselves a tier 3 here, newbie. Pushing in. Radiant's
top tower just Jackie Mao things, you know.
Yeah, we love him.
Dude, he went for Hurricane Pike on the silencer.
Oh, we
got a
replay. Watch the blip.
Oh, it's cooldown? Oh, it's on cooldown.
Oh, it's on cooldown. He didn't do the maths. He didn't do the maths. Oh,
why wouldn't he charge the stun?
He didn't do the maths.
Like 2 seconds later.
He didn't do the maths, Winter.
All right.
It was half a second out. Oh.
Maybe he was worried about the silencer farming that wave and running away, so he kind of didn't want to wait for... Yeah, it could be a part of his thought process, so he felt like he needed to try and get the kill as soon as possible. But didn't work out for him. So right now, Silencer picked up the Hurricane Pike and the rest of the newbie heroes smoked up. Silencer is not really needed at the fight there. He just needs to cast his global. And his team just needs to find an easy pick up lasso here. And they actually get the Alchemist. They have a ward here if he's gonna run into... No, he's not gonna run into the ward.
What's the build now? Is he just gonna go for the BKB? Full fight? Or, can he do anything else with that? I mean,
no.
Mjolnir Deso, let's go.
He's gonna get BKB, so he runs in, doesn't have to worry about the silence. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Still a very peculiar Alchemist build.
It really is. I don't think I've seen anyone else do this.
KP, they're gonna spot him out with the water.
Yeah, the smoke's gone, and immediately this time the jump in's successful. Envy's there to follow through with SVG. They get themselves a nice, tasty bit of gold into Envy's pocket.
They need a gem, so that doesn't happen. NewB needs to check for wards and make sure that NP is playing in the dark. Like, vision is going to be really important for the kind of lineup they have. Like, NP's lineup is much more late game orientated, so they're going to look to try and get as much farm as possible. So if they are forced to play without vision, they're going to have to, you know, stay in the base, and it's going to be really difficult for them to get farm outside of the map. So vision is going to be the next important thing that NewB has to control against NP.
And talk to me about this as well, something that we don't necessarily see all the teams do, but I think maybe something more done so in China. KP's decision to get the Aether Lens on the Batrider, is it just crucial to have that extra bit of catch potential from range?
I think it's not like, it's not down to region, I think it's down to player preference. I know certain players like the item. Like, personally, I like the item because it gives me more room for error. Like, sometimes I'm trying to blink into a position where I don't have vision.
Yes.
But having the lens means I can actually blink.
You've got a big kind of area of error. Yeah. Yeah, that you can still be successful.
And it gives, like, a good region. I kind of like the region sometimes. But I think overall, it's up to player preference what you want. Some players would prefer to get, say, I just want to BKB, so I can BKB and just blink in, and I don't have to worry about anything. Or some players might want to go for a use, for example. A use gives you movement speed and it allows you to have another tool to stop TP, since now you can't stop TP with the flame break. So it's just up to what you want to do and how you want to play.
Shadow Blade?
Wow, this is like a carry silencer here.
I mean, Kaka is really transforming. Into a core role with the.
Is he actually
going to
finish up a Silver Age as well? Like, Silver Age provides good stats, good intelligence, so you can actually deal more damage with your glaives, good attack speed. This silencer is not something to be whittled with right now. He deals so much damage. Have to draw aura.
I mean, he's hitting for a good 200 or so, and that's before
180 per pop before the glaives.
Before the glaives, yeah. And
80% of around 19 intelligence, so that's like
do the math,
and another 65 damage. Oh my god.
And that's pure. That's pure dirt. It's, as you said, when it kind of came in the draft, it was something that
And he's going to be bloodlusted, by the way.
Bloodlusted? Yep, we'll throw that in.
Bloodlusted, draw aura, silencer.
It's pretty nasty. I mean, MP, they've certainly got their work cut out. Again, I'm interested to see where MV continues to go with this one. On top of the BKB, he now does have 3,000 gold.
He definitely needs armor item.
He loves AC, I think, yeah, as
I,
you said.
I like AC next.
Yeah.
He's trying to go for this.
He wants to
Can
go for Kaka. Okay, he may be in trouble though. There is backup here. Oh. So he may have got the silencer, which is posing as a core, but it is just a support. MV will put the BKB and tries to TP out. Oh, is he going to do it? Oh, MV! He would only go and do it, wouldn't he? I mean, Envy, he continues to give us incredibly Envy-esque performances. It's no one else does stuff like that and gets away with
every
it.
Every time Owen casts his games, it always happens like something.
It's, you know, Envy sits down, he's like, OD Pixel Chan is watching me. I'm going to pull out these extravagant performances never been seen before. Amazing.
Oh my god.
Will it win in the game? That's another question, because NewB, they're now knocking on his door. They're up to the racks, and MP, they've got to pull a defense together here.
But where's their team?
Where's their carry? Well, he's sitting at one third of health, and he's back to base. Owie taking a nuke to the backside there from SZZZ. MP jumped. Oh, MP! He's just done it. He's not morphing out for once. The Aegis on the ground. Can they kill him a second time? That's the question. Looking for the jump in for the global side. It's never
on the
savage! MP! He's a genius! The bash to pick up there, securing the kill. U9 will get out. He didn't get the bash there. Envy giving a bit of mercy to the side of NewB, but
he got,
it's working out, Winter. It's
he
the out build.
Dude, he got greedy. He didn't like replicate out right away. He was like, I'm going to try and punch the enemy.
He didn't expect the bash yet. That was only just picked up. He didn't expect the bash.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He didn't know that he has a bash.
No.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness. And they see U9.
And Envy's like,
look at him. Oh, maybe he's going to find Kaka on the way around. They'll take the silencer instead. They'll surround him. Owie's there as well, the losing B. But good force. Using the force there, NewB. Getting Kaka back to safety. Owie, he's looking to dive. He's looking to chase. He's going past the tier two. Owie. Is the SVG going to make the jump? No.
That was a triple four-star action right there.
That's beautiful.
That's why you told your support to get a 4-star.
Don't get a Midas.
Get a 4-star.
Midas doesn't save heroes.
But I'm going to get a 4-star later.
Oh, what do we got?
Midas.
Oh, here we go. inside the mind of Envy, jumping in. Oh, there's a hero here. Oh, nice lasso, mate. I don't give a damn. I've got a BKB. I've got a TP flame break. What are you at, mate? It's 6.88. I'm off. You can't do anything about it. Chemical rage. Good spell.
There was like one more click. Anything would have killed him there.
But the thing is, he knew it was one more click, Winter, and that's why he made that play.
I'm sure in the mind. It was all part of the plan, you know?
All part of the Kakaku. Who is actually 9k and playing for NewB at the moment on the silencer. 12 for 7. It's a game that was looking pretty good for NewB at the start. Well, obviously, we still mentioned that MP had these strengths, and as you can see from this swing around, back into the hands of MP potentially now at this stage of the game. They have obviously lost. It's only the rain tracks, isn't it, on the top? Who cares about that? I don't even know what's in the game. But Abyssal Blade is now done for Envy. He's even scarier now in these fights. NewB have to be careful how they jump into this Alchemist, because if you're not disabling Envy and taking him out at the start, he's going to punch back incredibly hard.
He's going to kill anyone he sees with the stun and Abyssal. And right now, because of the BKB, he has the Morphling can't really burst him with the Adaptive plus E-Blade combination. So this Alchemist is right now a big problem for NewB. I don't think they have enough like physical damage to kill him through the BKB yet. So they need the draw to get... I guess you want to finish here. Maybe get a damage item like a butterfly, then you'll be able to deal with this Alchemist better. But as of right now, this Alchemist, Envy is a problem for NewB.
He really is. Kaka, indeed, as you mentioned, going straight for the Silver Edge, just needs about 700 more to have that done. He's already picked up the recipe, so preparing to finish off the Silver Edge.
I don't know about finishing off the Silver Edge now. Right,
you would
now,
like to see something else on Kaka?
Right now, I feel he needs a Hex because of the BKB on the Elk. I mean, it's a long way there, so getting a Silver Edge would provide you, you know, good stats right now for the price it gives you, and the damage reduction is really nice, the overall damage reduction when you don't have a BKB. But both the cores of MP have their BKBs up, so I don't know how much it's gonna, you know, change the game with the Silver Edge. I would personally prefer the Hex right now. I think he's gonna most likely get it after the Silver Edge. He's still gonna go for the Hex, but yeah, a later timing might, you know, allow the Alchemist to do a lot of damage in the game.
And I guess the question is as well, with this Alk build, he probably still looks to switch out the arm that for something, but all talking about the Alk.
Escape again?
Have they got the damage to kill him? That's the question. They lasso him back, initial new kit from the Morphin, but Envy pops the BKB, starting to try and walk this off. He's going to make it. They pop the Global Silence, but there's no real kind of follow-up initiation from NewB after their first jump in. They've just got to Global and run. Faith caught in the tree line. They know he's there, MP. They'll look for the Ogre Killers. SVG jumps forward. They surround Faith. They'll take something. But again, it really feels like NewB, you know, they must be scientists because they are baffled. They do not know what to do against Envy at this stage. They're trying to jump in and they just don't know how to kill Envy.
And Yunnan went for the Aghanim, so he didn't go for a damage build, but he's going for a more like split push, farm, you get more farm. They're gearing up for the late game. Like, they understand that it's not going to be possible for them to end the game right now. They're not going to be able to get any more opportunities to push the high ground. The game is definitely going to go for the long run and just going for a more farming, more economy build on the draw here. Going for more late game.
And here's the time to push really for MP. Both Lasso and Global Silence on the sidelines. I mean, Lasso's going to be up very, very shortly, but Global at least is a full minute downtime still. As MP ready to push in, and we'll see how much they can get done. Kaka already trying to harass back out, but immediately with the man start backs off. There's the lasso back off as he jumps in MSS with the three man and the follow up there. Crush from SVG. Owie comes in with the eclipse. They've taken down two. Owie survives here with the glimmer cane. He's going to TP out. He supports keeping Owie alive. He'll get himself back to safety. Envy walking this off like a walk in the park.
What a play by the Darkseer, Slaughter, and the Shadow Demon. Three of those heroes combining together to keep their carry alive. First with the Vacuum into the Crush, and then the Glimmer Keep.
The power of friendship, Winter.
The power of friendship is real. You keep your bro alive, you know. At all costs, you keep your bro alive.
Very, very sweet play. I mean, we have seen kind of dives and plays like that behind Tier 3s before that haven't gone perfectly, but that really did. You lose nothing. It's not the biggest kills, but it's the intimidation that MP are enforcing on NewB. They're like, you want to jump in? Go on, Owie. We'll jump in back on you. Beautiful three-man vacuum into the Crush. Owie just going ham, and he knows that he can. because Rhodes is there, and he says, be careful, my fair fella. I will protect you from these nasty men, and you will return to the land of the beautiful.
You sound like a Disney story, yeah?
I sound like a Disney story. Wow.
That's always a happy ending, yeah?
They're all. I do like a happy ending, Winter. Now, Roshan has respawned. NewB with the positioning to take it, and they can take it very quickly, so we'll see if they are going to ultimate indeed. They're just going to go straight into the pit. They know that they've got good control of the map around here. Question is if MP can get over here to contest it, and to be fair, the speed that NewB get it, this should be a freebie for them, by the way, isn't it?
And finally, KP has a gem, thanks to the support. Even with the Aegis on NewB, it doesn't seem like, oh, MP's going to be too worried. They're going to just keep doing their thing, keeping the lane push up with the illusions from SD and Luna, the Darkseer as well, pushing the lanes and trying to, you know, make it very difficult for NewB to make a play and get a pick off to push high ground.
Let's see what they can do. They want, they indeed, as you said, they need to find something with this.
Yeah, they want to force something where MP is not really.
I mean, MV's taking a bit of a walk up on the top lane. He does obviously have the bots to get back, but NewB are already looking to wrap around onto him. He's already botsing out. He's fine. He's back to base. NewB, they won't get the hero. They'll be able to start to pressure in this top lane.
He's going
to
buy Aghanim's for someone.
Who's he going to give it to first?
Luna Axe is pretty tempting, though.
It is. I mean,
you put your ulti on the Slada.
Winter.
Shadow Demon is also pretty good.
Shadow Demon, I mean, yeah. I mean, I guess it's very nice in terms of dealing with the bat when he jumps in.
Honestly, I think you do it on the Luna, and then
you do it on the,
and then
okay.
The Slada jumps in. You put the Eclipse on the Slada before he goes.
I mean, I feel as if, you know, if you're looking at MSS and you're saying if you're hitting walls like that, we'll give you the axe. You know what I mean? That was a beautiful wall.
That is true. Like the Darkseer axe actually gives a lot of damage.
Yeah, having a buffed up illusion of Drow, yes, please. We'll take that. But who did he go? Is he not finished it? No, Envy's still working on
it
now.
He's keeping buyback goal.
Yeah, you want to play it safe when you're putting this amount of pressure on you and keeping yourselves tucked into the base. But he does have the surplus now, so he can go ahead with the purchase. So we can expect that very soon from Envy. And
so
going to see
get,
the option.
Who's going to get the love from Envy?
Oh, Rose is standing close, and I think Rose got it. No, not yet. Yeah. Here we go. Who's gonna get it?
The Luna. Yep.
The Luna did. Owie.
It's the
getting the priority.
Dude, look at just wait for the vacuum into Slada Crush.
Oh,
with the Luna out here on top of that.
The heroes are gonna disappear so quickly. It's
this
pretty
is
insane.
Actually super strong. Like, yeah. I think it's one of the underrated Aghanim's upgrades of the game. It's really, really good.
I mean, I guess it's just something normally, if you're playing Luna, you don't really want to be building it yourself, do you? There's other items that you kind of need to get late game.
That's a good point, but yeah. I've seen players where they actually go for the Aghanim's as their probably second item after the Dragonlance or Hurricane Pike, they go for, and Helm, they go for the Aghanim's. I've seen it done before, but, you know, just like, not a big event, but some local events. And I think it's like pretty good. Because it actually provides you with a lot of stats if you're looking to keep fighting and you're not looking to, you know, drag the game too long.
Oh, an Envy. He's looking for the jumping onto S-Triple C and he manages to pop the linkers with the initial jump and then follow for Abyssal Blade. They do get a good lasso and Envy's around it and taken down out for 80, but it's the vacuum wall. Owie coming in as well with that Eclipse, bringing NewB incredibly low here. S-Triple C's trying to morph his way out of this one and NewB do keep themselves all alive as they survive a very heavy attack there from MP.
Envy didn't pop his BKB there when he went in. So he just got destroyed by the E-Blade plus Adaptive Strike combo.
Yeah, this morphling certainly still a massive issue. Skadi's complete for S-Triple-C now.
They're going to try to force Jackie to buy back here.
I'm actually going to see them actually come through the wall again. SVG in the crush off. Those illusions are already gone though, they've already passed through once it's been out, so you don't have to worry about going through it again.
So they dropped their wall, they dropped the Eclipse.
Still Jackie hasn't been forced to buy about 30 seconds.
They're just trying to use the illusions to slow the push down. Seems like it's going to be more than enough for them. NewB are really, really worried about going, they're going to just run in. Look at the damage the illusions are doing.
Oh, Rose! Taking a nuke to the backside, they are going to fortify. And at the least, it looks like they will hold on to the buyback of Envy, but NewB get what they came for, they get the racks. And Kak already looking to double back in with the Shadow Blades, see if he can catch anyone out here on the edge of the high ground of MP's base. But MP grouping up themselves towards the middle. They're all back up, did cost Rose the buyback, and they are now a full set of racks down on the top.
MP has to be really, really careful in the next few minutes. They cannot afford any big mistakes anymore. Like, Newbee is really strong at this stage. They have to be cautious when they're moving out. Like, the SD, he may be a support, but he's a very important, you know, member of the team right now in their base defense. They can't afford to give away any pickups on the SD anymore.
On this wraparound from MP. They come at, they're out of the base.
Global is up in 10 seconds though.
They've got the wall. They don't have Eclipse.
This is tough.
I'm gonna get the jump on here. I'm not gonna see the Nubia spotting them out. I'm already trying to burst down Rose. I'm gonna be able to nuke him straight away. The wall's gonna be dropped, catching out SCCC and Kaka Demonic Purge as well onto the Morphling. In fact, Envy's managed to find U9 on the side, got the jump in and finished off the Drow Ranger on his own. And at the end of the day, they'll be fine with that. They've got a vacuum back on SCCC as well. He's already utilized the TP. Envy closing in with the concoction. Pops the PKP to make sure that he can throw it. And Envy now getting in range, bashing him down. Can they actually kill him? Yes, they can. They've done it. Envy with the concoction. That was perfect. You know, he's charging it up. The global silence comes out. Kaka says, ha ha. And then Envy says, ha ha, I've got a BKB to make sure that I can chuck it.
This
is the solo
this
kill.
This fight is all Envy. This fight, he gets a pick off on the Drow, and then he makes that play there, getting another kill on the Morphling. Just all in all, like, great play from MP. The wraparound and Envy's initiation, Envy's first
They have move. To be careful with this push. They're pushing forward with just two Aoi, maybe getting a little too confident, but getting to the still three left alive. Indeed, it looks like Envy trying to come in to back him up. Got the Eclipse, Aoi moving forward, BKP and Glimmer catch up. Envy, can he find any more of this concoction? Doesn't look like he can. NewB get themselves far enough away, and that is Aoi utilizing the BKB down for a full minute, of course, again, and Eclipse is not there as well. Try and push in nonetheless, but they do have to be careful. U9's back up. And in 30 seconds, there will be more to deal with as well. Envy indeed is. BKB is still on cooldown for 3 seconds. They need to keep him alive. BKB in 1 second, he gets it out. And Chemical Rage, he's even thinking about turning around the back of him again. MSS! Oh my god, this dog's here! It's absolutely perfect play in that fight from NP as they catch three. They'll clean out the mid set of racks. Kaka buying back. MSS now with a Shiva's Guard as well. This has been some incredibly godly play here from this Darkseer. And SVG's always there with the follow-up. There's three heroes now down on Newbee. They do not have buyback. NP able to do serious amounts of damage here. Aoi picks up a refresher. Ready for the GG fight, Rose. Oh, he disrupts himself into the dodgy initial bit of damage. He's in a bit of problem. As can his team save him? No, they can't. Rose is out. Envy comes in, gets the stun on Test Triple C. Envy falling low. Again, the vacuum and crush from MSS and SVG. Test Triple C is forced to buy back. Kaka's out for 80 seconds. And NP clean up the top set of racks as well. There's still a tier 2 bottom protecting that final set, so they'll almost certainly back off and look to just get that lane pushed out. But still, MP turning up the heat, and NewBee don't know what hit them.
Oh my god, that's some teamwork right there, Darkseer and Slada. This is the reason why teams have been utilizing the support Slada a lot. It's so easy to execute it with the Darkseer, and it's so deadly as well at the same time. With the crush, the low cooldown crush, and the amp damage. They don't even actually need the amp then. Once the vacuum was out, the fight was practically over with just one stun.
And just look how much Aoi had enough money off the back of that fight. He's got refreshes and he's still got 3.8k gold in the bank.
I'm still waiting for that combo.
Which combo?
The Eclipse on the Slada with the vacuum.
I'm sure it's coming soon. I mean, Slada, SVG now has a Shadow Blade as well. Even easier for him to follow through the jump-ins from MSS.
Wait, basically everyone is gonna die. No, wait, look at their heroes.
Everyone is going to die.
No one has BKB. No one has BKB.
Why would you buy a BKB?
Dude, you're against the Luna.
That is true.
With Aghanims.
You should tell them that. Oh, there we go. Just each and every time. I don't think we've seen MSS vacuum anything less than three heroes at a time.
Oh my god, they have no BKBs on anyone.
Oh, poor old Rose though, he's not having fun with this Morph Seablade.
Life of a support, Owen. You know.
Yeah. Some KP. He's angry. He wants some blood. He wants some tasty, tasty anime blood, but he's not going to find it. MP, back in away. I'm going to allow themselves to be jumped on. Newbee again though, finding that timing where they're able to find the space around Roshan to be able to head in themselves and finish it off. We'll get themselves the cheese and the Aegis. MP just not in the neighborhood at all to contest this.
it. I just can't wait for it to happen. The double eclipse on the Slada and no one has BKB, even with the Aegis of Chiefs. They're still gonna die.
So we're gonna be like 22 beams coming out in a matter of seconds.
It's gonna be in like almost close to instant.
It's gonna. So big. Oh, it is literally gonna be a massive kind of iron cannon shooting from the sky down onto the heads of NewB. But the funny thing is, really, that NewB, they still can win this game. They're, even though two racks down, a bad fight, and NewB can just charge down the lane with this Drow and finish it. So MP have to be careful.
It's also about the first move, if they can actually make a really good initiation with the bat.
Yeah.
Like pick off Alchemist, like what happened in top lane. He didn't pop his BKB. He got lassoed, global, couldn't disrupt him, and he was just dead after. I think SD really needs, but he's very poor, like he can't really afford the Lotus, like he really needs to get one of the items to help him deal with the global, but not gonna have the luxury to do that as a support right now, having a really tough game. Darkseid on the other hand has the Greaves to deal with the global, so he's the only one that's gonna be able to save the Alchemist.
Oh, Envy, he's been baited in by an illusion, but it looks like he'll be okay. NewB, not looking to jump in off the back of that. KP's lapping his way over.
Yep. You get the initiation.
I mean, if at this point, who's KP looking to rip out the fight first? Because he's got a number of targets that he needs to worry about.
I think one of the big calls, the Alchemist or the Luna, and you make sure you get the global so the SD can't get the disruption on top of that. He needs, I think probably the Alchemist would be your primary top target. He's the one that's going to be able to jump and kill your Morphling with the Abyssal and the amount of damage that he has. Luna has not gone for, you know, the physical like damage build. He has gone for the Refresher Agonist build. So I think the main threat would be on the Alchemist. You want to kill him and get BKBs on your heroes so that the Luna Eclipse doesn't do anything.
I mean, is anyone even working? We see, what, 2.2k on U9. Obviously, Morph's not really wanting to give up a slot for that BKB.
A last item BKB, probably.
Yeah, there's just so many more things that SCCC wants to be holding, and indeed Butterfly is what he's looking to build at the moment with that quarterstaff, as we'd imagine. But NewB looking for a wraparound here. MP actually hiding, huddling in the tree line around the side shop. I'll see if they're prepared for this. KP jumping forward, MP grouped up. Who's going to get the jump? Rose to McKeppy seems to get a bit of vision as he comes close. He's actually going to be the target because immediately after that, SVG coming in with the 2-bounce. Oh! The Eclipse rips them down! 3 out! Oh! I think he managed to use the cheese to keep himself alive there on the drought.
Oh my god.
The cheese did save U9, only just, but that.
That's the BKB.
He's not right. I'm putting BKB, lads. Screw this. I'm done. BKB on the Morphling. SCCC does not want to mess around with that after he just saw the power that MP can rip out. SVG, he's just styling. He's got a Shadow Blade. U9, he doesn't carry detection. He's a core. Don't be silly. Oh! Envy?
Oh, he didn't have ultimate up and he was still hitting the tower.
Oh. Okay. So, it was a nice fight, but Envy dies and we're back on with the game. NewB will be able to push out this bottom lane.
That's how it feels to be a Cloud9 fan, yeah?
It really does. Suddenly, someone gets excited. They're doing it, but then NewB are like, nah. Oh, what a game indeed, though. 2019.
He was just trying to like hit the tower too much because he saw the Morphling at top pushing the lane and the Morphling TP'd. He might have miscalculated a little, thinking that he had like an extra 2 or 3 seconds, but Morphling just came back and just killed him.
Haste. Right, have we got the replay? Oh, okay, this is
the double eclipse. Look at that.
It's
no BKBs, they just die.
And that's triple C. Like, waveforms in.
Oh my god.
Look at I want to see U9's cheese. U9 cheese to the last minute to keep himself alive. SCCC trying to see if he can find a pickup on the back of it. But
and NewB pushing the bottom lane right now.
Yeah, I mean, does Envy need to buy back it? It might. I mean, 25 seconds is not that long. But at the same time, look how fast these guys
can
push.
Get a slaughter. Ooh, the Ether then.
Yeah, he's gone and he drags him in. SVG's down for a minute. He does not have buyback in NewB.
Keeping
their composure in a chaotic game. They found themselves the second set of racks. They'll move over to the mid to look to take even more. Envy will be back in 5 seconds. He's going to need to have the fight of his life here to hold on to this one, especially as he'll be fighting without SVG by his side.
Darkseid needs to pull off a big vacuum.
And there we have Envy with the jump in. SCCC full incredibly low. There's the vacuum onto two. SCCC going to get himself out? No, the Aegis is out. Get themselves back up to the high ground. BKB has been used already by Aoi.
They have one Eclipse right now. Refresher is 50 seconds off, so they won't be having that in their arsenal right now.
25 seconds and we're going to see SVG back in.
He can basically BKB and hit the Rex if he wants to. Oh, he's hitting the Rex.
Envy, cooking up a concoction, jumps in, S-Trip C, juking it out with the waveform. And OKP trying to find the follow-up, and immediately the stun is there. Envy falling low, though. Could he keep himself alive, trying to back himself out of this fight? The Glimmer Cape's not going to be enough. He's out. He'll buy back immediately. Unite's been able to finish off both Aoi and MSS. They'll all buy back as well. And now NewB trying to retreat, but they've already done the damage. Mega Creeps are out.
MP can still win this game. They need to take just the last set of Rex from NewB. It's still possible.
Can they do it?
Aegis is out. They have to push out their lanes.
But look how much that fight cost them. Those three buybacks, setting them back a clear 6k.
I think it's still possible for them to win. Like, they just need to...
All of NewB have buybacks as well.
They just need to land a Darkseer plus Slada Crush again.
Oh, there's a Hex on the Silencer. Winter, this is extremely hard mode. At the least for MP at this stage to win.
Okay, there's another BKB on U9, so the double Eclipse probably not gonna do so much now.
Unless they can get the jump on him before he gets it out.
Luna might have regretted going for the refresher here. They need more physical damage. Like, Alchemist has been what KP just needs to do. Lasso Alchemist, he's the only like main physical damage, and the rest of the heroes pop their BKB, and Luna can't kill them. Once Alchemist is out of the fight, MP doesn't have enough damage to win. That's the problem MP is facing right now with this refresher build on Aoi. Might have regretted it. I mean, it looks nice on paper, you know, having the Aghanims and refresher, but it's like a little too all-in. Like, the enemy sees it. Oh, we just need to get our BKBs up right now, man. You're not gonna win the fight.
And that's what they did. NewB reacting very nicely to MP's builds and plays, and now pressuring the tier 4s. What can MP do about this? Looking for the smoke and the wraparound on the side. MP, who's he going to get the jump in onto? He's looking for KP on the back line. He's trying to get the back out of the fight. The vacuum is there. Onto a triple C as well. They turn around, get the bash out. SVG forced out. He will keep himself alive for the time being. Aoi coming in with the Eclipse of the BKB, but KP gets the dragon, brings MP out of the fight with a buyback there. KP may have just secured the game for NewB. They're forcing the rest of them back to base, and indeed, with MP on the sideline for 2 minutes, that'll allow NewB to clean off the tier fours and on to more. They're looking for kills, looking for Aoi. SVG taking blades to the backside. We'll get himself back to base. Aoi trying to force a triple C as well, but with the nukes, Aoi's out as well. It's all falling apart for MP. NewB take the victory there with some very, very smart decisions at the end. That buyback from KP immediately as he dies, gets back in, gets the lasso off onto MP, securing the big kill that NewB needed there to close this one up.
What a game, dude. Just what a game.
A very entertaining game.
And we just keeping the game so interesting with his build and his decision making.